Hey everyone, Kassandra Brooks here with AMIClubwear.com. And you know what? It's almost Valentine's Day, and that means we have the right to eat as many sweets as we want. Whether you have a Valentine or you don't have a Valentine, feel free to indulge in some sweets. I'm gonna show you in this video how to make dressed up chocolate covered strawberries. They're really, really simple, so don't, you know, get nervous about making them. They're so easy and they're so good. I guarantee you bring these, you're gonna have Valentines all over the place. So anyways, let's get started. You only need a few ingredients. You need some fresh strawberries. I just got some strawberries from the store. It would actually be a good idea to maybe get these at a farmer's market if you could find one that has them still. You can maybe find them with the long stems. Those look a little more elegant, but these ones with the little stems are still cute as well. You want to wash these and you also want to dry them. Make sure you get them as dry as possible, because if they're wet, that's actually going to seize up the chocolate and it's not going to be a good story. So we have the strawberries, and then you also need two different chocolates. You need a white chocolate and a dark chocolate. I just got whatever was on sale, the Nestle Toll House white chocolate, and then this was just the Ralph's brand dark chocolate. So we got those, and they have directions on the back of how to melt the chocolate. It's really simple. Pretty much, I just put them into separate bowls, and then you microwave them separately. So I started with the white chocolate, and I put the white chocolate in there for 1 minute. And then it's an older microwave, so the wattage is lower. If you have a new microwave that has Super Duty wattage, you wanna lower the wattage to like half, maybe 70%. So I put this in there for a minute, and then I stirred up the morsels. They were all getting all melty, but there were still some, ones that hadn't melted yet. So I stirred it, then I popped it back in there for 15-second intervals. So I think I probably microwaved this for about a minute and 45 seconds. You don't want to overdo it because you can burn the chocolate and then it doesn't taste sweet. So you want to make sure you do it slowly at a time. Slowly, slowly. Anyways, so this is the milk chocolate. Same procedure. Just microwave it for a minute at first, stir it, and then 15-second intervals until it gets nice and melty like this. And then you are also going to need a little baggie of the dark chocolate. Pretty much what I did is I just put a few of the morsels in here, and I opened up the side where the chocolate wasn't at, just so that it could breathe a little bit, and I microwaved it for 30 seconds on this side, kind of squished it a little bit, and microwaved it for 30 seconds on that side, and then I think I microwaved it for like 15 seconds after that, and you just kind of like squish it together, make sure that it's, you know, all mixing and melting. So this is what we need to get our strawberries started. And then you also need a pair of scissors to cut a hole in the baggie. But let's get started. These are my already washed and dried strawberries. I'm gonna set them over here. And now to get that like elegant tuxedo effect, what we're gonna do is we're first going to coat the strawberry completely in the white chocolate. So we're just gonna dip it in here and just really get it completely covered. I kind of spin it around. Okay, and then just kind of let the excess chocolate drip off. And then what would work is you could place this onto, you know, like a flat surface with parchment paper, or just right now I'm going to place it on this little plastic plate. Like that, and the chocolate will dry. So I'm going to continue making the strawberries, because you wanna dip them all in the white chocolate first, let the white chocolate dry, and then we're gonna re-dip them into the dark chocolate. Drying time for the chocolate does vary depending on how hot the chocolate was when you put it on the strawberry, the room temperature, I mean, all these different things. So a little hint is you can pop them in the freezer for about 3 to 5 minutes, and that will really speed up the drying process and make things go a lot quicker. However, if you're making a lot of strawberries at one time, chances are your strawberries at the beginning of the line will be already dried by the time you get finished dipping on the other one. So depends on how fast you're going through everything. So I popped these ones in the freezer for about 3 minutes, and now I'm going to dress them up in their tuxedos. So we'll just start with this guy over here. And pretty much what you want to do is you take your dark chocolate, and you're just going to dip the strawberry in at an angle, because you want to get the angled chocolate so that it looks like he's wearing a tuxedo, you know? So we're going to take the strawberry and dip it in at an angle on both sides. There we go. And then you just do the same thing. You let this guy dry. So I'm gonna do it to all the strawberries. So now our gentlemen are all dressed up, but they're not ready for the ball yet. They need to get their bow ties on. That's why we have this little baggie of chocolate. So pretty much you can get one of the baker's bags if you want, but it's just as easy to use a little baggie at home. So this is just a little snack size sandwich bag, and I'm gonna take the tip of the bag, squeeze the chocolate out of it, and then I'm gonna cut with the scissors the tip of the bag off. You don't want it to be too big of a hole because then you won't get good precision. Okay. Let's do a little tester. All right, the chocolate's coming out good. So now for his bow tie, what we're pretty much gonna do is we're gonna give him buttons going up the shirt. So it's starting from the bottom of the little indent right there. So we're gonna give him two buttons. And now for his bow tie, we're just gonna pretty much make two little triangles. Voila! There's our chocolate covered strawberries. So, pretty easy. Very elegant, very delicious, and it's gonna be a great little treat for Valentine's Day. I also wanted to share with you something that's gonna pair so amazingly with these strawberries. What doesn't go good with strawberries like champagne? So I'm gonna show you how to make some Valentine cocktails using champagne, because champagne and strawberries go so good together. Let me bring over our ingredients. This is just champagne. You can get any kind that you like. We need champagne glasses. And then this is Chambord. It's a raspberry liqueur. It's really sweet. Girls love it. And then I just got these little sweetheart candies. These are just perfect for Valentine's Day. Classic Valentine candies. We need to pop the bubbly. Now we're gonna make a few different versions of a Valentine cocktail. First, we're gonna make a cure royale, which you just put a splash of Chambord in it, and it's really good, really sweet, and it's really festive. So we're just gonna put a little bit of that in here. Just enough to kind of turn it pink. That's a good amount. So that is a cure royale. You just put a splash of Chambord with the champagne. Now, I'm just gonna show you one that's super easy. Strawberries and champagne. You wanna put a strawberry on the outside to garnish the glass, and then I also put a strawberry in the glass, but I like to cut off the stem. Strawberries and champagne. Now we're gonna do one that's a little bit off the wall, but it's perfect for the occasion. We're gonna drop in our favorite colored sweethearts. So I would just pick cute ones. I'm gonna go with pink because it's kind of a theme, I guess. My favorite color. Just pop a few of those in and you have a Valentine's sweetheart cocktail. And plain champagne is always good as well with strawberries. So many delicious things to choose from. I'm definitely gonna have one of these. And what should I pair it with? Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Here's to wishing you a very delicious Valentine's Day. Stay trendy and I'll see you around. Cheers!